The Securities and Exchange Commission orders the shutdown of online news site Rappler for violating the constitutional restrictions on foreign ownership. The SEC says it's merely enforcing a decision back in 2018 canceling Rappler's certificate of incorporation. It ruled the site allowed foreign investor Omidyar Network to hold Philippine Depositary Receipts, or PDRs. PDRs allow foreign entities to invest but not control companies in the country. The SEC now points out Omidyar donating its PDRs to the staff of Rappler is merely an afterthought in a bid to escape a violation that was already committed. It adds Omidyar also waived its rights to the PDRs when proceedings against the matter were ongoing. Well, Rappler vows to fight the SEC shutdown order by using all legal means. Rappler's lawyer, Francis Lim, says they can take the matter up to the Supreme Court. The news site adds the proceedings that led to the SEC order were highly irregular.
We strongly disagree with the decision. And fortunately for us, we have legal remedies available to question the decision before our courts of law. So rest assured that we will do so on behalf of the Rappler Group. And we are confident that at the end of the day, we shall prevail. There is a question whether this SEC decision was properly done. And in our view, it was irregular, highly irregular, because we were not given due process.
Rappler CEO Maria Ressa, unfazed by the SEC order.
We've gone through this before. I think you've seen the way we've reacted to it. We have plans A through Z. It's like quicksand right now. Our goal is to continue holding the line. You've heard me say that forever. We're not going to voluntarily give up our rights. And we really shouldn't. I've continued to appeal for that, because when you give up your rights, you're never going to get them back. Starting in 2019, I had 10 arrest warrants, right? So these new normals should not be normal. We should demand better.
Bayamuna Chairperson Neri Colmenares slams the SEC's closure order on Rappler. Colmenares sees the move as a way to silence fearless journalism. He warns the shutdown of media institutions like Rappler, ABS-CBN, and alternative news sites only further destroys the country's pillars for checks and balances. The Office of the Prosecutor in Davao City dismisses the cyber libel complaints filed by Davao-based businessman Dennis Oy against ABS-CBN over its news reports. The Office of the Prosecutor said the complaints were dismissed due to lack of probable cause. Oy earlier claimed ABS-CBN stories on the Malampaya deal, which quoted the graft complaint against him, were libelous. But the prosecutor's office said they were not defamatory. Last week, outgoing Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi withdrew his libel and cyber libel complaints against ABS-CBN and six other news organizations over their stories on the Malampaya deal. ABS-CBN is the parent firm of this news channel. The lawyer of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. believes the Supreme Court took into consideration Marcos's inauguration this Thursday in its speedy decision on petitions challenging his client's electoral victory. The High Court on Tuesday voted 13-0, declaring Marcos is eligible to run and be elected to public office despite his conviction in a tax case. The Supreme Court took only just a little over 1.5 months to decide on the petitions.
The Supreme Court is cognizant of the reality of the situation that the Constitution provides in explicit terms that the term incoming president shall start on June 30. What is at stake is the confidence of the people as to the legitimacy, appropriateness of the assumption of office to move of workers of the presidency.
America's second gentleman, Douglas Emhoff, has arrived in Manila. The husband of U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris is leading the American delegation to Thursday's inauguration of President-elect Marcos Jr. Meanwhile, China's vice president is representing Chinese leader Xi Jinping at that event. Joyce Belancha has more on the preparations for tomorrow's ceremony.
President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.'s inauguration on June 30 will be simple, solemn, and traditional. France Imperial, one of the heads of the preparation committee, says the program is all set, except for some minor details that are still being finalized. Just like what Marcos said in his vlog, they will stick to tradition during the presidential inauguration. On the morning of June 30, President-elect Marcos will visit the Malacañang Palace to greet outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte, after which Duterte will be given departure honors. Marcos will then proceed to the National Museum for the inaugural ceremony. The program will start with TV host and actress Tony Gonzaga singing the Philippine National Anthem. After this, the ecumenical invocation will follow. A 30-minute military and civic parade will then be held, and the inaugural song, Pilipinas Kumahal, will be performed by artist Chris Villonco and the Young Voices of the Philippines Choir. The Senate President will read the joint resolution by the National Board of Canvassers proclaiming Marcos and Vice President-elect Sara Duterte. At exactly 12 noon, Marcos will take his oath before Supreme Court Chief Justice Alexander Hismundo to be followed by a 21-gun salute. Marcos will then deliver his inaugural speech. His camp has not yet bared the contents of the message. An inaugural reception for other officials and foreign dignitaries will be held after, still at the National Museum. Marcos will then go back to the palace to formally assume office. There, he will administer the oath of his cabinet members and will host an inaugural dinner for the guests. A concert will be held in Mindiola in the evening. According to the Department of Interior and Local Government, around 1,250 guests are expected at the National Museum. Around 18,000 policemen, firemen, soldiers, and emergency services personnel will be deployed in Manila.
Tinitingnan natin, no, pinaluluwag yung lugar para doon sa ibigay ito dito sa mga pupunta rito natin, mga kababayan, supporters ng ating mahal na Pangulo. Tinitingnan natin kaya nagtatanggal na ng iba pang mga chin barrier, tinitingnan din natin yan, at para mapaluwag pa natin yung lugar.
The Interior Department appeals to the local governments to provide venues for public viewing of the inauguration.
Kami po ay we also encourage the different local government units na mag-sponsor ng mga live streaming sa kanikanilang mga lugar para po doon sa mga kababayan natin ay hindi na kailangan pumunta pa at manood personally.
While rallies will be allowed in Freedom Parks, the Interior Department is encouraging protesters to stage them online instead.
Ang pakiusap lang po namin sa kanila, please keep your protest peaceful. Huwag na po tayong makipag-gitgitan. Huwag na po nating gawa ng eksena pa ito.
The Manila Police District and the Presidential Security Group also held a dry run for security measures.
What I can tell you today is a simulation of what will happen on April, on June 30.
That's all you can share?
Yes.
Meanwhile, among those who are expected as guests is Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan. He will attend on behalf of Chinese President Xi Jinping. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
Bagong Alyansang Makabayan Secretary General Renato Reyes asserts they will not be holding a protest during Marcos's inauguration that will cause chaos and violence. The group will hold an assembly tomorrow at the Liwasang Bonifacio in Manila. Reyes also denied their group will march towards the National Museum, the venue of Marcos's oath-taking. He also called the police's suggestion to bring the protest online ridiculous.
This statement that you should just go online to protest, it's really ridiculous. It's hypocritical and stupid because it's the state which has been preventing and suppressing our presence online. Remember, our website was blocked last week by the NTC. We have to show the incoming administration that we are not going to stand for the same repressive policies that have been happening and being imposed during the Duterte regime. We have to be there to be present to remind the incoming administration that we're not about to forget the abuses committed under the Marcos dictatorship.